Hi friends, before going to start my session, I wanted to tell that if you are a teacher on that time, share this video with your students. If you are a student on that time, share with your friends. It is more helpful to them. Now I wanted to say that if you wanted the explanation in other languages, you can tell in the comment box. Now let's begin history class 10th chapter 8 Indian freedom struggle. This chapter we have already completed till Subhash Chandra Bose. In today's session let us see Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, his full name is Bhim Rao Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar strongly believed that the political independence was meaningless without social independence. Political independence is a meaningless. It has no meaning without a social independence. He maintained that if a person from the lowest of the low classes did not get social and economic freedom, the political freedom did not matter at all. First, he was believed that person who is belong to the low caste, it does not matter how much their political and economic freedom are there except social freedom. He did not see India as a mere and non-living political entity, but as one which had a living side to it, with the feeling and emotions too. He has another face of thinking on the time of independence. He carried out as a study of caste system and come up with a plan of eradicate it. In order to prove that the untouchability has been denied basic facilities, and it has started Mahat and Kalaram temple movement. When we see that in the olden days, we see that the untouchability is there. The persons who was related to the untouchable classes, they has no social freedom in the society of India. And that time, the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar have been started like Mahat and Kalaram temple movement. And he attained the three round table conference and given valuable suggestion. On the time when the Britishers are called for the round table conference, on that time he was attend all three round table conference, and he has given valuable suggestion. And difference of opinion between the Gandhiji and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar with regard to the leadership of untouchables and upliftment of Harijans, and he demand for the separate electoral constituency for untouchable, and brought about the conflict between Gandhiji and Ambedkar. On that time he was asked about to provide separate constituency related to the untouchables. On that time the conflict has been started between the Gandhiji and Ambedkar. Ambedkar was a divan in the court of Maharaja of Baroda, and he carried out the responsibility as a member of the Mumbai Legislative Council and later the Viceroy Executive Council and great responsibilities. Ambedkar did not join the Congress party. Instead, he established organizations. Now, on that time, Ambedkar did not join to the Congress party, and he was started his own organization like Bahishkruta Hitakarani Sabha and two separate parties named the Swarashtra Karmika Party and Republican Party of India, and he published various newspapers like Parabuddha Bharata and Janta Mukanayaka and Bahishkara Bharata. He stayed away from the communist and socialist approaches and worked towards the progress of agricultural labor. He was started many newspapers like Mukanayaka, Janta and Bahishkara Bharata. Those kind of papers he was started, and he was stay away from the communist and socialist approaches, and he was given more important related to the progress of agricultural labor. The constitution was formed as a guiding force of independent India. Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad was chosen as a president of Constituent Assembly. Later, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was unanimously chosen as a chairman of the Constitution Draft Committee. First, we see that when our India was get independent on that time, the main thing is that to wrote the Constitution, and on that time the doctor they formed the Constitution Draft Committee. That committee was headed by Dr. Babu Rajendra Prasad, and later Dr. B.R. Ambedkar became the chairman of the drafting committee, and he advocated equality in the constitution and gave legal protection against the practices of untouchability. When he was the chairman on that time, he took legal protection against the practices of untouchability. On the ancient time, we see that the untouchables have been suffer from many things. Untouchables should stay out of the village, and untouchables did not take water from the common well, and untouchables should not attain the common practices of the society, and untouchables would not go to the common temple of the society. Those kind of things would be held on that time. The Dr. B.R. Ambedkar have been totally against to those things. The Indian Constitution considers practices of the untouchability is a crime. In our Indian Constitution, we see that the practices of untouchability is a crime. After independence, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar became the law minister. Though he had been inspired by the modernism and intellectualism and Western philosophy, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar remained and faithful to his native principles and by the caste system. And he gave up the Hinduism and he was moved towards the Buddhism, and he believed that the same changes that Marxism brought about through the violence and bloodshed, it could be brought about by the non-violence and peace through Buddhism. He was also awarded by Bharat Ratna Award for his lifetime achievement in our India. Bharat Ratna Award is a great award which was given by the government of our India for the honorable persons who served their life for a society. When he was helped to write the constitution on that, after that he became the law minister of India, and after that he totally inspired by modernism, intellectualism and Western philosophy. And Ambedkar has been totally believed with faithful and native principles, and after that he changes his religion, Hinduism to Buddhism, and he was believed that the Marxism brought through the violence and bloodshed, and brought about the non-violence and peace through the Buddhism. Those are all things which are related to the Ambedkar. Lastly, we see that one great slogan is there. Let's see. A great leader without newspaper is like a bird without wing. A great leader without a newspaper, like he did not have a bird without a wing. It means a leader without a general knowledge, he did not have any value, and it should be like a bird without a wing. The bird without a wing, he can't move from one place to another place. Those kind of situation of that leader without a newspaper. Now let's move on. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you all like this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel.